China's decision to cancel a $32.1 billion U.S. chip order is a game changer in the global tech industry. But what factors are driving China towards self-sufficiency? Today, we will discuss China's progress in chip self-sufficiency and explore the impact of U.S. chip restrictions. Later, we will find out why even Bill Gates is expressing concern about the consequences of the U.S. chip restrictions on China's massive growth in chip industry. The Chinese chip market is undergoing a significant change, driven by U.S. chip restrictions. China aims to achieve 70% self-sufficiency in chip production, focusing on high-end chips with advanced technologies. To achieve this goal, Shanghai Microelectronics, the sole producer of complete lithography machines in China, is intensifying its research and development efforts in this area. Chinese enterprises are now utilizing domestically produced lithography machines, marking a milestone in their pursuit of self-sufficiency. As the world's largest chip market, China heavily relies on imports, particularly for high-end integrated circuits used in consumer electronics. However, the demand for mature chips is growing rapidly due to the increasing adoption of technologies like artificial intelligence, cloud computing, and big data. In response, Chinese chip manufacturer SMIC is expanding its capacity for mature chips, focusing on 28-nanometer technology. These efforts to enhance self-sufficiency have started yielding results, as China's imports of integrated circuits have decreased significantly. In the first quarter of this year alone, imports decreased by 22.9%, with a reduction of 32.1 billion chip imports compared to the previous year. This trend not only reduces China's dependence on foreign chip suppliers, but also poses challenges for overseas chip giants aiming to profit from the Chinese market. Do you know the difference between front-end and back-end lithography machines? In the semiconductor chip manufacturing process, these machines play distinct roles. Front-end lithography machines are responsible for creating lithographic masks, projecting chip patterns onto silicone wafers to form a design. On the other hand, back-end lithography machines etch patterns on silicone wafers to form chip circuit components. The front-end machines require higher resolution and precision, while the back-end machines prioritize processing speed and etching ability. Manufacturing front-end lithography machines poses greater challenges, demanding high-precision optical systems, mechanical systems, and stability control. ASML, a leading company, excels in front-end lithography machines, achieving high-end processes of 5 nanometers and below. However, the availability of advanced EUV lithography machines remains limited. Domestically, Chinese enterprises focus on back-end lithography machines for chip packaging, with production currently at 90 nanometers. Despite this, advanced packaging technology holds significant value for domestic chips. It enhances chip performance, reduces power consumption, improves reliability, and lowers size and cost. Embracing advanced packaging technology strengthens chip market competitiveness, attracts customers and partners, and fosters the growth of China's domestic chip industry. But how will the frequent restrictions on Chinese chips by the United States impact China's self-sufficiency? Recent developments suggest that these restrictions are actually accelerating China's drive towards self-reliance. China has canceled 32.1 billion chip imports and embraced domestically produced lithography machines, showcasing its determination. Foreign media and even Bill Gates have voiced concerns about the consequences of these restrictions. Gates has long argued that such measures will only make China more self-sufficient in chip manufacturing while causing the United States to lose high-paying jobs. This perspective aligns with reality, as China's chip industry demonstrates signs of self-sufficiency while the U.S. technology sector faces significant job losses. If the United States persists with these restrictive measures, it will primarily impact its own company's profits and result in further layoffs. Consequently, the United States may regret its actions when it's too late. As China's chip production grows, American companies like Qualcomm, AMD, and Micron have already experienced significant setbacks. Qualcomm's net profit dropped by a staggering 42% in the second quarter of 2023 due to declining chip orders and prices. Is the world underestimating the determination and potential of China's chip industry? Recent reports suggest that China chiplet technology has made significant advancements, with Tongfu Microelectronics successfully developing the 5 nanometers process technology. By overcoming the Western blockades on EUV lithography machines, China is poised to achieve mass production of high-end chips. But what has been the driving force behind this progress? Huawei, in response to the U.S. chip embargo, has heavily invested in the development of quantum chips and considered the future of the market. With a staggering 110 billion won investment, Huawei has now unveiled a new patent for superconducting quantum chips, solving a long-standing challenge faced by Intel. In fact, China is now forging ahead with its own domestically produced lithography machines, launching a photon chip production line and aiming to establish leadership in the domestic chip market.